Welcome to the final video on the Unit 12 playlist of our Chemistry Matters series, a recap of Unit 11, Nuclear Chemistry. Unit 11 began with our students using cloud chambers to visualize nuclear particles. And I showed how a Geiger counter can be used to hear and count nuclear particles. Through these processes, we learned how to identify the different types of nuclear decay products found in radioactive elements. Our students then practiced identifying isotopes and writing isotope notation for alpha, beta, and gamma decay equations. We explored the usefulness of radioactive nuclear decay particles as medical tracers and as a tool to destroy cancer cells. We even learned how to calculate the age of fossils by using radioactive half-life. Our students then investigated nuclear fission, represented by the animation you see here. But even more important for our Georgia science standards is the process of nuclear fusion, and how the nuclear fusion process produces all of the elements on the periodic table that are heavier than hydrogen. Nuclear fusion is a process that occurs when two lighter nuclei combine to form heavier nuclei, and it's always accompanied by a release of energy. Because the larger atoms are often more stable and less energetic, tremendous amounts of energy are released in this process. In fact, the energy from fusion is probably the most important to our lives. Fusion produces the energy that the sun releases, so it's the energy that sustains life as we know it. Every element larger than hydrogen on the periodic table was formed from fusion inside of stars. Within a star, hydrogen nuclei combine their nuclei with other hydrogen nuclei to form helium. Then other hydrogen nuclei combine with helium nuclei to get lithium. And the fusion keeps going on until iron, which has 26 protons, is produced. As the iron atoms are forced closer to the lighter atoms, they're smashed together and forced to create the heavier elements we find on the periodic table. Increasing gravity causes more and more fusion, and all of that fusion releases an incredible amount of energy. This energy release is called a supernova explosion, and this is how all the elements heavier than iron were created. Back in the classroom, far away from the stars, our students demonstrated a simplified simulation of fusion by smashing marshmallows together to form models of helium, which were further smashed together to make models of carbon. Before Unit 11 was complete, our students were assigned a tiered performance task. Each student got to work on an assignment of their choice. These performance tasks focused on fission, fusion, and the uses of radioactive materials. And to help summarize all of these ideas and confirm our understanding of why nuclear chemistry is important to us, we visited a radiochemistry laboratory to investigate how radioactive materials are detected in environmental samples. By now, it should be clear that effective methods of testing for radioactive samples not only exist, but laboratories exist in which you might carry out such investigations yourself as a possible future career. Remember, our Unit 11 toolkit has a document on which you can find the list of Georgia science standards addressed in Unit 11. And our Chemistry Matters series toolkit has a complete list of Georgia science standards for chemistry found in all units across the series. We've now reached the end of our Chemistry Matters series, but don't forget that those toolkits I've been mentioning are great resources for additional information. And as you recall, we've created multiple closer look videos for much of the content throughout the series that can help you further explore a wide range of topics. I'm Rachel Garner. On behalf of everyone here at Georgia Public Broadcasting, we hope you found this series to be both educational and thought-provoking. The staff of GPB takes very seriously our mission to create, produce, and distribute high-quality programs and services that educate, inform, and entertain audiences, and enrich the quality of their lives. And of course, we've done our best to meet this goal with Chemistry Matters. Thanks for watching.